Happy morning. Today we are going to have session on final accounts and year-end process. Few of the book settings which are required to be known for balance sheet and stock purpose. We have a book setting called stock valuation, which will show us what valuation method we need to apply for calculating the stock values for our balance sheet and trial balance. We have multiple stock valuation methods like cost rate, which is taken from product master cost rate if it is a general product, and it takes cost rate of the batch if it is a batch product or manual tracking product. Purchase rate again is taken from masters. We have average rate, which is again calculated based on average purchase rates. Last purchase rate will be based on last purchased invoice. Zero rate FIFO is one of the highly used, like first in first out, based on whatever stock is available. FIFO basis will calculate those stock valuation based on the last purchase rate based on stock availability. And we have one more setting called manual stock valuation for balance sheet. If we enable this, it takes valuation defined in the master's closing stock. Let's say we enable it to yes and go to master closing stock and provide value 31/3/2018. Save this entry. After saving this, when we see this profit and loss, since we have enabled manual stock in book settings, it is by default ticked. And when we click show valuation, the stock value will be same as what we have defined in the closing stock.
Stock value.
To see the actual stock as per the stock summary, untick this and click show. To show the valuation, closing stock value as per the stock summary. Let's say stock summary show. So 698 is the value, and the same is being shown here in the stock in trade. Even in stock summary, we have an option to select the valuation, where we can select different valuation methods for calculating our stock value. Let's say we select FIFO, click apply. The stock valuation changes based on the FIFO. These valuations will impact balance sheet, profit and loss. So generally, we have to define the stock valuation method in the book settings, based on which the profit and loss and balance sheet will take into effect. Moving to the next section, like creating of partner's capital account, you have to go to master general ledger. Let's create one max partner. One capital, and the account group should be partners capital. As soon as we select partners capital, we get a profit share ratio.
Let's say capital account means just account group will be capital account.
Yeah, if it is a normal account, it will be account group will be capital account. It will not be partners capital. When we select partners capital, based on the number of partners, profit sharing will vary. Let's say we have two partners. So 50-50 is the partnership.
Partner. We have 60-40, 70-30, whatever.
So based on their agreement, they can define it is 50-50 or 60-40 or 70-30 based on their agreement. This will be used when we do a year-end process. Let's go to accounts, final accounts. Profit and loss. Let's see the trial balance for this financial year. If there is any difference in opening trial balance, let's say there's a difference of 2,30,000. We have to fix this in accounts opening balance. As per the opening balance, the debit should be equal to the credit amount. Now 2,30,000 debit amount is missing here, so let's use those capital account. Here itself you can find there's zero difference now. Refresh the trial balance. You can see here there's no difference now.
This can be either by capital account or there are chances where some entries have been missed. And opening balances can be entered only in the year when the book has begun. If you're in the next financial year or you're having multiple years in a single database, and if you alter anything in the opening balance, you will have to switch to the first year and then change the opening balances. You will not be able to alter on that same year. And if you want to alter opening balances in that particular year only, then you will have to split the data and then change the opening balances. That is the only possibility.
Basically, the opening balance is feed it based on the last year's closing trial balance, which the auditor approves. How to move to the next financial year? To start the billing in the next financial year, go to file, switch to next year, and you can initiate your billing for the financial year 18-19. To see the trial balance, to see the profit amount, which is saying undistributed P&L. Why it is showing here is we have not closed the last financial year. How to close the last financial year? We have defined the profit ratio as 50% and 50%. Go to file previous year. This undistributed P&L will be shown across even in balance sheet also in the next year. So whenever customer complains that there is undistributed P&L, it is
Pretty clear that
year end has not been done for the previous year.
Basically, the profits have not been divided among the partners.
Let's see the P&L. Profit and loss statement is divided into two sections, trading account and profit and loss. Trading account is a mixture of the sales and purchase entries, opening stock and the closing stock. If there are any direct expense and income, it will be appearing in the trading account. Profit and loss is purely income and expenses indirect. All the indirect income and expenses will be part of the profit and loss statement. Based after those expenses and income, it will calculate the net profit. Before that, it is a gross profit which is coming from sales and purchase. Now this
gross profit is carried forward on the profit and loss.
Yes.
And after all the expenses, it's showing in the net profits. Okay.
Now to share the profit ratio, profit based on the ratio.
Go to the balance sheet. Next. And the net profit will be carried forward to balance sheet now.
There is the net profit which was shown in the P&L statement. This will have all the debtors, creditors, all the loans taken, loans given, closing stock value, profit. Balance sheet will not include any expenses, whether it is direct or indirect. All are covered as part of profit and loss.
Okay.
Yes.
Undistributed profit clearance.
So now clearing this undistributed profit in trial balance, you have to go to miscellaneous, year end process. Click proceed. It will ask, do you want to close? Once you give yes, it will automatically pass journal entries for all the profit and loss. You can see the journal entries which are being passed. All the expenses will be moved to P&L account, and from P&L the profit will be carried forward to the capital
as per the ratio.
So you can see there are two entries which has happened. One is all the expenses being debited and P&L being credited. Again, all the trading account has been
debited. All the sales and purchase got transferred.
So sales and purchase getting transferred to trading account. Trading account is getting transferred again to P&L. All the expenses getting transferred to P&L, and P&L is finally getting transferred to capital. So this is a sequence which is being followed automatically when you do a year-end process. These entries, there is no need to pass manual entries. If somebody has passed manual entry of profit, like after sharing the profit they have passed manual journal, it has to be deleted and it has to be done through year-end process to have a clarity.
Now the balance sheet will have this capital accounts updated.
Yes.
Okay.
So you see the balance. Yeah. Net profit is gone in this, and capital account is increased. You see the ledger of capital account. It will show an entry, journal entry, which will show the profit being transferred to capital. So initial capital was 1,15,000. Now after profit, capital is increased to 696. Then switching to next year, when we see the trial balance, it will not show any undistributed profit.
Capital account values are updated.
Everything is clear now because capital posting has happened, year end has happened basically.
Now any withdrawals happen for the partners means? Those are normal drawing accounts.
Normal drawing account.
Okay,
again moving to the previous year, if you try to do any entries in sales and purchase, it will not allow because we have closed the year end. You can see this year end process already done. To enable again, we have to go to year end process, delete year end entries. So what it will do is it will delete all those journals which we saw previously. Now when you click edit, it will allow you to edit and save the bill or do any changes in the entries part. So today in this session we have learnt about how to create partners capital account, how to enable book settings for manual stock valuation and the valuation method, and how to provide closing stock value in masters based on which the profit and loss, trial balance and balance sheet gets affected, and how to do a year-end process to proceed with the sales and purchase entries, like all the transaction for the next year.
And how to reopen.
And how to reopen again the previous year to modify entries or do the pending entries of the previous year. That's it for the today's session.
Thank you.
Thank you.